Welcome back to Eagle Fieldhouse for our second game in the Saturday night doubleheader. It's Nixa and Father Tolton Classic in a battle of state-ranked teams. Nixa, number 3 in Class 6, and Father Tolton, number 6 in Class 4. Got a lot of stars on these teams.
Yeah, honestly, it's in my opinion, it's wrong that they're number 6 in Class 4. They should be higher. And I think Nixa should honestly be higher, too.
Nixa will 1,000% move up, especially if they win this game.
If they win this game, there's no reason why they shouldn't be.
No, Father Tolton beat Chaminade, which is the second best team, or the number 2 team.
The only team besides Liberty that's above Nixa in Class 6.
So that's what I was going to say was, even though Class 4 is absolutely loaded with talent, how do you beat the number 2 team in Class 6, but in Class 4 you're the number 6 team?
Yeah, that's
I don't know how that works. But
honestly, though, Father Tolton, they could be a state semifinalist or state finalist in Class 6.
Hey,
and I think Blair Oaks could, too.
Let's just jump right in, and we'll talk about some of the stars you can watch on this team. And I'm going to go ahead and pick the impact players tonight because it's a matchup that's going head-to-head that we learned about. Noah Engelman for the Mixed Eagles.
Yeah.
All right? And the reason why, he's tasked with guarding Javon Porter.
Yeah,
give us a little insight on Javon Porter.
Well, the obvious thing, he's Michael Porter Jr.'s brother. This is Michael Porter Jr.'s alma mater, won a state championship here in 2016. And he has a lot of talent. He's a Pepperdine commit, 3-star, honestly could be higher.
He's like literally 0.2% away from being a 4-star.
He is so close to being a 4-star. 88 ranked in the country, 20-something in his position, I think, in the country. So that's a big one. And Noah Engelman, he won't back down from anyone. He will
he'd
guard anyone. He will have 0 points, and he could be the best player on the Nixa team right this
tonight. Honestly, he could win player of the game
with 0 points.
But some of the other players on this Father Tolton Trailblazers team, I mean, you've got 6'11 out of Javon Porter. You've also got 6'7 Justin Boyer, 6'9 Evans Apollon. I mean, you got some height.
Yeah.
But if they go inside, Nixa could have some trouble.
Yeah. They're going to have to box out. You can't just go for the ball against a team like this. You got to box out, put a body on someone just to get a rebound. And they're going to have to rebound to win.
Yeah, Coach Jeremy Osborne, got a chance to talk to him. It's the Battle of the Osbornes tonight. You got Jeremy on the Father Tolton side. He's in his 8th year at Father Tolton. And then, obviously, Jay Osborne in his 30th and final year at Nixa High School. And some news that is news that, like, we haven't gotten to say on the broadcast yet, but it's been out for a few days now. Jay Osborne going to be inducted in the Hall of Fame, Missouri Sports Hall of Fame.
Yeah. So I'm shocked it took that long, honestly.
Me too, and I think it might have just been they were waiting for his career to be done with because, I mean, the Nixa basketball program as a whole is already in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
So this is going to be a fantastic matchup, Trey. We don't have any keys to the game graphics made, but you want to give us a few keys to the game for the Eagles?
Well, for the Eagles, obviously they have to rebound. That's a thing in every game. You got to rebound to win games, and especially against a team with this height.
Got a height advantage like this.
Yeah, and free throws, that's pretty obvious. I mean, it showed Ozark, they left a couple points on the board early, and it could have came back. I mean, it did come back on them.
They would have won that game, yeah.
Yeah, they only lost by 2, and they left points on the board early with some free throws that could have made that game a lot better. So free throws, they're a killer in close games. Last year, Nixa could have beat Kickapoo for the first time in, I don't know how many years, 11?
Something like that. A lot.
Yeah, but they missed some free throws late and in the middle of the game. And you look at a free throw in the middle of the game, and you don't expect it to make
a
big impact on the game. But then you look down and won 2-point game, and you left 3 points on the board early in the first half. And those points did come back on you. I mean, you got to score every possession, basically, if you're going to win good teams like this.
Trey, what do you think the Eagles are shooting from the free throw line this year, percentage-wise?
65?
57%.
Oh, that is not good.
So
that is not good at all.
You're going to want to see the Eagles improve a little bit. Best free throw shooter so far this year, though, Combs and Barry. And Barry struggled shooting free throws last year.
Shaquille O'Neal is leading the team in free throw percentage right now.
No, that's not. He's not quite Shaquille O'Neal. He's shooting it pretty well.
This year.
Looking at some of the Eagles' Cale Combs going to have to step up tonight.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's had some great games. I mean, only 17 points or 18 points in the Eagles win over
only 18
Willard.
Points in three quarters.
Yeah, and he probably could have had 30 if he really wanted to.
Yeah, but he didn't need to. That's the thing.
And we just lost audio.
Which one?
Oh, well, my bad. We lost internet down here, so that's why we thought we didn't have audio. I don't know. It looks like we're good, though. Had a basketball hit our setup, so hopefully we don't lose audio throughout the game, but if we do, that's why. So, you got anything else, Trey, to just lead us into this game?
I don't know. You kind of threw me off. Well, we had a fantastic game last time. Hopefully we see another one here.
Yeah, that last game, 69-67, and it literally went down to the final millisecond, Trey.
Hey, you said we could go 8-for-8 tonight, so I'm going to make it 5-for-5 right now. Kyle Pogue is up there.
Cool.
I just had to make it 5-for-5.
All right, well.
Oh, and we got Sam Russo in the building.
The Stars are out again tonight. Big Tao and J-Band's here tonight.
Yeah, Alex Stein up there.
Alex Stein's up there. We got
Jason Jones, Riley Childs in the building.
Southwest Missouri basketball's here. Scoreboard guys here. We got a lot of guys here.
We got a lot of guys here.
So we're going to go ahead and step aside. Well, we didn't get a light spectacle. We didn't get the hype video, but the atmosphere is set.
You don't really need it, honestly, in this game.
The stage is set. Tolton Catholic will be in their road blues. Nixa in the home whites. And no matter how many Stars you got on the court, you got to play Nixa at home.
Yeah.
And that's not an easy task to do.
That's a tough one to do. It's tough to win. It's really tough to win on the road. It's really tough to beat Nixa on the road. They haven't lost at home in a long time.
So, number 6, Tolton Catholic. Number 3, Nixa, and we are underway at Eagle Fieldhouse.
Fulton Berry won the tip. Nixa starts the game early.
Wow. You know, that's impressive. Colton's 6'7". I don't care.
Porter's 6'10".
Kale Combs drives to the basket. No one was there, and an early turnover there for the Eagles.
Yeah, that's not what Nixon needed. They need to score on almost every possession. You can't waste possessions like that.
No. You know, honestly, though, Tolton really hasn't been much. Like, they've scored a lot, obviously. But it's you'd think with all the stars they have on their team, they'd be scoring like 90 points a game. They're not doing that. So he banks a three. I guess the bank's open. I don't know. And Tolton's going to pick up in a press with a 3-0 lead. They go up to Jarrett Nelson. Hand off Noah Engelman.
Good pass.
Go to Barry. He can't finish. And rebound to Tolton. Now on the other end, that's a freshman Aaron Rowe. Finish off the glass. Not the start you want for the Eagles.
Tolton in a full court press.
Oh, Noah nice Engelman, move. Euro step, and finish with the left hand. Well,
he's not going to have zero.
That's what I was going to say. He's not going to have 0 points. He's going to at least finish with two.
The only – or one of the two juniors in the lineup, he's going to have to play a big part tonight. Good defense by Barry. And Noah Engelman able to get a big rebound there.
Yep. Cale Combs with it now. Ruffin. This is a game where Cale Combs can definitely prove himself.
Yeah. Watch out for 11 and white. And 20 and white.
It's true. Combs with it up top. 6:40 to play. 5-2. The Trailblazers lead. Noah Engelman with it. He's going to drive to the basket. Blocked by Javon Porter, but fouled on the way up. Noah Engelman, a chance to have 4 points here early. Well, Trey's not going to have zero.
That's true, yeah. I was expecting to see an entire offense or an all defensive display out of Engelman, but he's showing up early on the offensive side.
Well, still got to make the free throws. I guess probably shouldn't have assumed that.
Oh, my goodness, in and out.
Yep. Tough break there. Second one on the way from Engelman.
Not yet.
Not yet, almost. He took a little longer than I was expecting, to be honest with you.
Well, you said that whenever he first got the ball.
Oh, true. It's been a long day.
It has been. Got a full day of basketball today.
Takai Chivas with it. Now a three-pointer on the way. No good.
Ruffin with the
rebound. I don't even have a number four on the roster, Trey.
Number four.
Do you happen to know who that is?
No.
Just have to wait till he scores, I guess. Who were number four in the NBA, Trey?
I don't know.
I think it's Justin Boyer is wearing number four. I think that's what it is. Or no, it's not.
No, it's not. Justin Boyer is still wearing three.
Well, Colin Ruffin with it left side. We'll figure it out.
Straight up on Nelson.
Nelson.
Doesn't even matter.
What a move, and he'll finish with the left hand. That is a fantastic move.
That's just what Jarrett Nelson does. He loves that move. He goes to it all the time.
You know who it is?
Yeah.
It's Isaac Porter, the younger of the Porter brothers.
Good pass.
Takai Chivas with the layup, and it's 7-5 here. Tolton leads.
Throw a lob to Barry.
Ruffin with it, spinning through the lane and finishing is Jarrett Nelson. Yeah, I would have liked to see the lob to Barry, but that'll work too.
That works, yeah. Didn't see the lob city there, but.
Oh, well. That's what I said. I don't think that, you know, it would have happened. 5 minutes to play. Jordan Turner heads to the scorer's table.
Like to see him in. Not starting.
Had 17, and the Eagles win over Willard.
Couple of big threes. A few.
Isaac Porter, no good for three. Rebound by Ruffin.
Makes it take their first lead of the night.
Tie basketball game right here.
Yeah, Ruffin Nix is getting into the inside very well.
And
good move,
blocked
yes.
there, but a foul. Tagged to Javon Porter. And it's really shocking because who has all the height, Trey?
Yeah.
But they said, hey, look, you might have the height, but my post players are better than yours.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly.
Shaquille O'Neal at the line right now.
I don't know what you're talking about. Who's going to make this?
Colton
Berry, good for
Colton Berry.
First one.
I love that, dude.
Turner flashes that he's going for the shooter.
Whoa. That's interesting.
Colton Berry will come
we'll
out.
See a smaller
we'll see
lineup.
A, yeah. Which is probably going to be a little more athletic. I like it.
I like it.
Honestly,
Berry,
even though.
Colton Berry just made both his free throws.
I don't know why he's not a bad free throw shooter.
Well, compared to last year, you know.
Student section started reading the book. That's what it is.
That's been going on since seventh grade.
Yes.
I love that guy.
Aaron Rowe, the freshman point guard, picks up his dribble, kicks it to Isaac Porter.
Noah Engelman is denying ball right now, and he is doing a great job.
Yeah.
That's a good defense by Combs. Jarrett Nelson with the rebound.
And, oh, almost could have had a foul. That would have been a second. Foul.
Yeah, that would have been big.
Now Ruffin on the other end. He'll drive to the basket, and what a finish by Colin Ruffin.
They're letting him play tonight.
Okay.
I like it, yeah. Colin Ruffin, what a finish, though. That's impressive. That's something that very few people can do.
Now here goes Javon Porter. Just kicks it right off. Free throw line jumper, no good.
Jared,
and rebound by
Colin.
That
foul, too.
They'll go up ahead to Jordan Turner. Throw the lob to Cale Combs, and
just
that's
a
not
little bit high.
Good.
That would have been a that would have been impressive.
Dang, man.
I would have loved to see that.
That would have been good. We'll see the younger Porter check out. And Noah Engelman's going to check out. Oh, no. Cale Combs is going to check out real quick. I don't think he liked the way he landed there. He's taking off his shoe. That's not good, Trey.
His sock fell down. That's why he took off his shoe.
That's why he took him out of the game, too.
Yeah, that's why he took him out of the game.
Inside Javon Porter.
My. No good, and we got a foul here on Justin Boyer. Noah Engelman,
very impressed.
He's
with
trying
him
to get in his head. He just elbow bumped Javon Porter. I love Noah Engelman.
Wow. Great defensive start. I was going to say, prior to Nixa figuring stuff out, I was going to say defense was just a myth in this game, but
it's not.
Nixa's figured out their defensive struggles. Ruffin up top. Now Turner. Looking
Nelson
in the paint, wants Nelson.
Advantage. Oh, good pass.
Finds Kell and Ruffin for three. No good, but looked like more of a pass to Nelson. Out of bounds off of the Trailblazers.
See Combs check back in really quick.
Combs coming in.
Engelman
checking
yeah
out.
I was very
four
impressed
points
with
out of Noah Engelman and a fantastic defensive effort. Go inside, Jarrett Nelson.
Oh, my goodness.
And the finish. He said, you know what? You're 6 foot 10 or 11. I don't care, Trey.
Jarrett Nelson. Oh, now
six
we got
tonight.
Jackson Bell on Porter, and I like that too. Jackson Bell has been very impressive on the defensive end this year so far.
A little bit of a height mismatch, so what?
Yeah, there was one there too.
And
with,
you've got Jarrett Nelson sitting right there. To
yeah,
help.
But he's not as athletic as Bell is.
No.
Oh, he is playing great defense right now.
James Lee drive blocked by Cale Combs.
We called a foul on that.
He is not happy with that. Let's see it on the replay.
My, that is not a good call.
I'm just glad we got a good replay to see it.
That was a really good replay.
Lee's first free throw.
Ball don't lie.
Still doesn't lie, Trey.
It's December 18th, 5:50 p.m., and ball does not lie. Never has.
He'll make the second one, though.
Yeah,
that's just
kind
of how this stuff works, even though it doesn't lie. Oh,
ball does
really
lie.
Doesn't lie.
Ball really doesn't lie there.
2:33 to play here in the first quarter. It's 13-7 Nixa over Tolton. Cale Combs with it. Bell brings the stream. Screen. I don't know what I was saying.
It's been a long day, Ryan.
Cale
oh,
Combs spinning. Oh, can't finish, though. That's something he would typically finish.
That was a good move, though.
Aaron Rowe now on the other end. It's very impressive to have a freshman point.
Yeah.
2 minutes to play here. Rowe with it right side. He's going to take a jumper. Nelson was all over that one, and he still gets it to go.
I'm impressed with him as a freshman. Oh, good pass.
Nelson going to go up with the left hand. He
Jared
hasn't had
Nelson with eight.
I can say this because he's my best friend. He's kind of not had the year he's wanted to so far, but
well, this
eight big ones
it
right now. And the Eagles have a six-point lead. Justin Boyer with it. He'll drive. Fadeaway jumper. No good. And the rebound goes to Ruffin.
Wow, this is the exact start that Knicks was hoping. What a move.
What a move by Cale Combs for three. No good. Rebound by Javon Porter.
This place would have went nuts if that went
I
in.
Thought he had it.
I thought he did, too.
Porter transition three. No good. Rebound by Jordan Turner.
Wow. Knicks' defensive effort has been so impressive so
you're
far.
You're saying rebound Jordan Turner. A good game. Colin Ruffin off the screen. No good. Nixa yet to make a three-pointer.
It's been been a sloppy start, or sloppy couple possessions here.
Aaron Look at Rowe, the defense. What a move.
Look at the offense, too.
Timeout, Tolton Catholic. We're going to see Evans Appelin check in, 6'9", junior. Let's step aside real quick. It's 15-11, 52 seconds to play in the first quarter. Back after this from the Tri-Lake Shootout. .2 to play here in the first quarter. It's 15-11 Nixa. A battle of state ranked. Ooh. It was a good start.
It was a really good start.
Ruffin with it across the timeline. Now give it off to Kale Combs. Noah Engelman. Now Barry, who checked in at the break. Love to see Turner get some space and a look at three. Oh, well, he'll drive to the rack and finish. That's something that we talked about with him after the Willard game. He's been working on that a lot in the summer.
Yeah, he's going to the basket.
It was something that we didn't see last year.
Yeah.
Javon Porter with it now. The three-star recruit finds someone in the corner. Can't get it to go, and we got a foul. That's a foul. He just got tripped.
I don't know about that.
He got tripped. I mean, it's a foul.
No, he didn't get tripped. He tripped over Turner. I don't think that you can give Turner the foul.
All right, fair enough.
I'm just saying, I don't know. Fair. From my angle, it didn't look like one.
All right. I get what you're saying. Javon Porter with it up top, 12 to play. Get it into Evans Appelin. Spinning through the paint with the left hand, gets it to go. That could have been a delay of the game. Oh,
yeah, he's out of bounds.
2 seconds to play. Ball does not lie. Not that anyone argued that call. He was out of bounds, but still. Two to play. You'd love to get a basket here. I think they're going to try to get it to Turner, who, in case you're wondering, has Javon Porter on. Get it to Ruffin. A lot of contact here from half court. No good. Way short. But at the end of one, it's 17-13. Nixa over Tolton Catholic back after this. Got a pretty high seat in the blue and gold.
Got Zach Howell on that team.
He'll get into the paint. An easy bucket for Evans Appelin.
He's got four, despite not starting tonight.
Interesting to note, Nixon was in a zone there on the last possession.
Yeah, that is interesting.
Ruffin putting dribble moves on. Eagles yet to make a three tonight. They get into Kale Combs, who has not scored. Trey.
Wow. I didn't even notice that. James Lee gets
that,
a foul.
I say that hoping I'm jinxing it and they throw like an alley-oop to him right now or something.
They're not going to throw an alley-oop to him.
Give it to Jarrett Nelson. Out to Ruffin. No foul. Wow. A lot of contact there. Aaron Rowe, and he throws it down. Whoa.
I didn't know he could dunk.
It's a tie game. That's a freshman on the biggest, probably the biggest stage, honestly. Combs took that one personally. We going to get a push off?
No.
They're going to talk about it. They'll call a block. You know what's funny is, the ref that was closest to Coach Osborne, Coach Jeremy Osborne, that is, he said, Coach Osborne was saying, push off, push off. The ref said, yeah, and then didn't call it. That's what's awesome. Combs gives it off to Barry. Now Engelman. Up top, calling Ruffin, a lot of contact there, and they'll call the foul.
Got a pass interference on them. 15 yards on the first down.
Did you see the play we had today in our game?
I saw
where
that.
The kid didn't even go to catch the ball. He went to go shove the kid over. Oh. Third and fourth grade basketball is entertaining. Jordan Turner in, Engelman out.
Oh. Nixon will be in the bonus for the rest of the half.
That was not a good situation
there.
It could have been really bad. Ruffin. Combs brings the screen. Not Combs. Barry.
Oh,
Ruffin
my.
Trying to
How
finish. No good.
Foul?
They're letting him play. And that's going to be a blocking foul on Colin Ruffin.
Why did you say that they're letting him play?
Sorry, what's that?
Why did you say they're letting him play?
They are letting him play.
As soon as you said that, they called a foul.
Honestly, though, Tolton has a light six foul. Like, usually it's not letting them play, but they should probably be about 15 on one side and 10 on the other.
Yeah.
If you're calling it like a normal game. So Javon Porter doesn't even hesitate.
He hasn't hit a three tonight.
He isn't.
Which is interesting with how much he shot.
Yeah. Jordan Turner with it up top. Kale Combs. 6 minutes to play here in the second quarter. Combs still scoreless on the night. Tried to give it off to Barry, and that's just, there aren't many teams around here that have the length that this Tolton Catholic team has.
Yeah. That's a bucket against almost any team around here.
He's handing off to Barry. Barry's two-handed slamming it.
Yeah.
I believe I saw a Nate Perrier edit that looked exactly like that play right there.
It wasn't against Catholic, though.
No.
They're Tolton Catholic, not Springfield Catholic.
Oh, do they get it into Jared Nelson? Yes, and that saved a very interesting play. Ruffin with it. Give it to Combs.
Good pass.
Find Nelson in there. He gets the defender in the air. Count the bucket.
Jared Nelson with 10 tonight.
What a
play.
Have a game, Jared Nelson.
On three people, and he does not have a height advantage in that.
He got killed there. I'm shocked they didn't call that on the floor.
I am, too. I'm shocked he made it.
He got killed. So Nelson to the line. Give the Eagles a three-point advantage, and he does. Well, that's a good sign.
That is. Don't say anything.
Knock on wood, but Jared Nelson did his free throw. Love you, buddy. Aaron Rowe with it. Dude, Nelson is having a game
he
right
is.
Now.
He is. 11 points. 11 of Nix's 20, and he is almost single-handedly the reason that Nix is leading right now. Almost a back tip by Ruffin.
Javon Porter, he'll
good
fire another
Nelson.
Three. No good.
Uh-oh.
Except he kind of had to do that. And Aaron Rowe will take a pull-up jumper.
Oh, my. He
can't
it.
Hit it. Javon Porter, no good. That's what
That's
three stars looks
That's
like?
That's a foul? Nothing?
What in the world? Dude, if we would have let that happen today at the center. Oh my.
We might have had a riot. Osborne is not happy right now.
Which one?
Both of them.
Jordan
really.
Turner off a screen.
Oh, almost got the N1-3.
I thought he was going to nail it.
I thought he was too, and that would have been the most Jordan Turner thing ever. He loves doing that.
All right, look, that's a foul, but we didn't have anything in the sequence down there on either team.
That one was a foul.
Yes.
This one was too.
It could have been on anyone down there. It could have been on me or you, honestly. Turner's first free throw, good.
Oh, Aaron Rowe has two fouls early.
Trey, let's go ahead and talk about it now that it's happened. It took three-star Javon Porter
a long time to
12
score.
Minutes to score. Yeah. I mean, man. Goodness. No, not 12 minutes. Wait, how long are the quarters in high school?
Eight minutes.
10.
10 minutes, wow. Yeah, that's a long time to score. Noah Engelman coming in for Barry. I like that move. I like this lineup, really.
I'm digging it.
You really just said I'm digging it on a broadcast. Jordan Turner, 3 for 3 on those.
You expect that out of him.
It gives Knicks a 4-point cushion.
Javon Porter with it up top. Now into the paint. Evans Apollon. Nelson straight up.
That's textbook post defense on Jarrett Nelson.
It is.
I love seeing Jarrett Nelson play defense like that.
When he plays like that and doesn't get out of his game and try to smack down and stuff like that, he's a very good defender. He's strong. I mean, you're not just going around that.
Yeah, you can't, you can't go through that. I mean, if you go through that, you're going to get a charge.
Yeah.
Or a blocking foul, depends on how the refs feel that night.
Combs drives to the basket. No call.
Nothing.
He's going to take that personally. Pump fake. Can't finish, man.
Rough start for Combs.
Javon Porter.
But here's what the fans came to see.
Yeah, and the layup's good by Porter. He's got four now.
Shocked it's four. Only four.
Right.
That was an impressive finish, though.
Turner gives it off to Noah Engelman. Now Combs. Roughing in the corner, going to the paint, Jarrett Nelson. Nelson backs his defender down and gets the foul.
Goodness.
All right, let's see. Fakes one way, he's not falling for it, and then that's when you're going to get the foul.
His hands went down. That's what it was.
Foul counter, 9-3 here. Nelson's first free throw, no good.
Nixa will be in the double bonus for 3:50 of the first half.
Wow.
That's almost half of the second quarter. Makes the second, makes it a 3-point game.
24-21, Nixa leads. Give it into the paint.
I'm not sure if that's a smart move with how good Nelson has been guarding him.
Honestly, 3-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound by Nelson. Now Ruffin, he wants to go fast. Give it off to Cale Combs. Combs to Engelman. Find Jordan Turner, you can't leave him open for three. He drills it. I really did not think that was going in.
I did not either. That just rattled around the rim, got the shooter's roll.
And I think it rattled Tolton a little bit. They looked a little awkward there.
Oh, boy.
Cale Combs gets a steal, and he'll throw it down. That's quite the way. Technical foul. After all that's happened all game, you call a technical foul for that? We have it. We'll watch it right here. He just screamed at him. Seriously?
What a dunk, though.
Yeah, great play. I just can't believe you called that.
I didn't keep that replay going. Are you kidding me? Oh, my goodness.
In this magnitude of a game in that situation. Sorry, I just had to give Kale a message. Come on, man.
Justin Boyer gets the shooter's roll on the first free throw.
They're talking down there. We've got a lot going on right now. Hey, you want me to say it or no? Ball doesn't lie, Trey. Jarrett Nelson is talking his mess right now.
Well, why not? I mean, he's got a 3-inch height disadvantage, and he's been doing a great job of guarding Appleton.
I'm just going to be honest. I think he just woke a beast.
And Jarrett or Colton or Kale?
All of them.
Every single one of them, yes.
Osborne's still chirping him.
So I guess in Arkansas and Missouri now you can't get it done without a technical.
Yes, I don't know. I said on the one broadcast, it's a good thing it didn't go over. I said, you don't get a tech for that Missouri, Kale. But you do, apparently.
Yeah.
Now Justin Boyer with it. Chivas and a travel.
Oh, my goodness.
I can't believe that was called.
That's true. That's once again, textbook Engelman. Defense by Engelman. I mean, he's playing great. Yeah, that's a travel. Oh, my. This crowd is lively tonight.
Yeah. It's not necessarily big.
It's not big, but it was loud for that those technical free throws. It was loud.
Well, everyone was getting into it, honestly. Engelman with it. Give it to Jarrett Nelson. Or Combs is on the bench, though.
Yeah.
Ruffin, handoff to Bell, but when Combs gets to check back into this game, just wait.
That's a good
great
play,
pass
Bell.
And a great finish by Jackson Bell. It's a 9-point game.
I love seeing Jackson Bell do that. I mean, that's what he needs to do. I like him. I think that he's a great player.
Boyer and a charge.
Oh my.
Wow.
Oh my.
They I think they did a favor when they called the technical foul. I'm going to be honest with you. Shocked we didn't get
there's
a foul
a
there,
of,
honestly.
There's
yeah.
a lot of contact here. He's talking to him right now.
I mean, 57. Ruffin is telling. Engelman gives it off to Bell. Bell ripping drive. Can he finish? No, but a foul's called, and he'll go to the line there. Oh, to shoot two.
If that was on the ground or in the shot, he's shooting two. Doesn't matter. Well, Lee's got three.
Oh, wow.
There's a lot of players with foul trouble right now.
There's a lot of stuff going on right now. You got three coaches
Porter tried to check in, and
he didn't go to the X. He's going to get – I guarantee you at Nixa, he would get
a first.
Okay, I have seen this. I don't know his name. That ref right there has called the technical for exactly what we just saw, and he almost did it again.
Well, just because you're an NBA player's brother doesn't mean you can check in whenever you want.
Right. They said, hey, go to the X, and he still didn't go to the X.
Yeah, he still didn't go all the way.
He smacked the table and said whatever.
It's an 11-point game for Nixa. It's been a strong second quarter.
Aaron Rowe and across the timeline.
Noah Engelman's back playing defense.
Yep.
Noah is so good.
Go inside, Justin Boyer. A foul. Oh. Ooh. That's going to be on the floor, though.
It's on Nelson, just his first 15 foul for the Eagles.
Hey, that's fine. Look, here's my – I don't know how it was a hold, though, but here's my thing with Jarrett. He gets five fouls. If he doesn't use four of the five, he's getting cheated. Okay? I'm just going to be honest with you.
Someone's open. He did find him.
Javon Porter gives it off to the point guard, Rowe. Finds Boyer wide open for three. Bang. Turner across the timeline. He's got 8 points tonight. Unlikely names with a lot of points for the Eagles tonight. Nelson and
Nelson's
Turner.
Not really an unlikely name for a lot of points, but
it's so far this year. Oh, travel.
I thought he got rid of that.
Well, Coach Osborne's got something to say.
I don't know how that was a travel. I mean, first of all, his feet didn't move, and then he got rid of the ball.
They're going to talk about it, I'm sure. Pete Meyer's in the game?
Keith Pete Meyer in the game? What's going on here? He doesn't even know who he's going in for.
He's getting roughing. I don't know.
What is going on?
A lot of stuff's going on.
And it's an 8-point game for the Eagles.
Yes, 33-25. We've had a fantastic game so far. Just a lot of stuff has happened in a very short amount of time. Up until about 5 minutes ago, we had a very clean air ball. We've had a very clean basketball game. Go ahead.
I could watch Noah Engelman play defense all day.
Me too.
He didn't touch that ball. No. Oh, what a move.
Oh, Turner pump fakes. 30 seconds to play. I say you take the last shot. You don't have your point guard on the floor, though.
You don't have Cale Combs or Colin Ruffin. Yeah. You got your two best players on the bench.
Well, Jackson Bell's just going to drive to the basket. Can't finish. Rebound goes to Keith Pietmeyer with 20 seconds to play. Turner drive to the basket now. Almost finished over the 6'11 Porter.
Porter got the foul?
No.
Oh, okay.
It was from the back.
I was going to say, because they called that before he touched it. So I was going to say it couldn't be on Porter.
Well, just to be honest with you, don't want to see foul trouble in this game.
Yeah.
Like, I'd rather see both teams at full strength going at it. This is a fantastic matchup, you know? No need to ruin it with anything like that.
Jarrett Nelson comes back in the game.
So, I've got a bold statement here, Trey.
What?
Cale Combs has 2 points in the first half.
He won.
He's
going to
finish
half.
With 20.
He did against Parkey.
Just telling
four.
You right now.
He had 4 in the first half, and he ended
happy.
With 24. Good defense.
Boyer in the oh. corner, bang! 2 to play here. Get it into Pete Meyer. He does play baseball, but
not gonna see it.
Won't get a shot off. We'll go ahead and take a break. It's 34 to 28 in a battle of state ranked. Nixa over Father Tolton. Back after the halftime break. 16 more minutes of fantastic basketball, man. That's, it was hard to get over the first game, and then we came out the way we did the second
one,
game.
Yeah.
Man. Something to note, Cale Combs, 2 points. Javon Porter, who is a 3.9-star recruit,
four.
Has four. Five.
Whoa.
Five.
Four? What?
He has five, apparently.
That's not what I have.
Well.
I just have two baskets.
Didn't he hit a three? No?
No.
I don't know.
I don't know.
It's Knicks of basketball here, regardless.
Well, and, with the way that Noah Ingram has played tonight, I mean, he's been so good on the defensive end. Almost had a turnover.
They get it into Engelman, and just like the first half, he'll kick off the scoring here in the second half.
He's got five tonight for someone that we thought would be only a defensive
him, yes.
player.
Five is a good amount for him. Justin Boyer with it, swung around to Aaron Rowe.
Colin Ruffin getting a big steal there.
Ruffin with it. Euro step. Kicks it off to Nelson, and he's fouled. I thought they were going to go to Combs in the corner.
I thought they were, too. But Nelson with 12. He had a very productive first half. That is some move.
And he's fouled on the way up. Oh, I honestly, typically he finishes that.
Yeah. That's three on Boyer, who's had a very good game with 10 points.
Been a threat from the outside, and the bank is open.
The shooter's roll.
We've now seen three shots that aren't typically banked in this game. So, and they've all been on that goal, too. Okay.
I guess that goal's bank is open.
Yes. Chance to make it a 10-point game here, and he does.
That is a very quick start, 4-0 in the first 40 seconds of the second half.
Now the freshman, Aaron Rowe, on the other end. I was impressed with him in the first quarter.
I was, too.
Or first half. For just being a freshman, very impressive player. Shot goes off the glass to Kai Chivas. His first points of the second half. First points of the game, actually, for him.
No, that's his fourth. Scoreboard's off.
No. Who's running that?
Some guy with the name Hartwell.
That's crazy.
He's wide open.
They're going to get it into Nelson. Blocked at the rim by Apollon.
Now we're going to see Ruffin guard him.
Porter goes into the paint to Apollon, feeding the big man after his defensive work, and that's a charge. Give my boy Jared Nelson an Oscar, maybe. He might have done more selling there. No, he got shot.
He sold it, but he got that's a foul, but he didn't fall over.
He smacked the ground, too, as he was going down.
He is getting a standing ovation right now.
This isn't the first time we've seen that. He likes to get into people's heads.
He likes to play towards the crowd.
Yes. Turner with it. Interesting to see him guarded by Porter.
Well, they're in a zone. Well, no, they aren't.
Combs has it.
They were to start the second half.
Gives it off to Turner.
He's going to let it drive all the way to the basket.
Can't finish. Just a little short. I think he was shocked
that he was that open. That's... Oh, he lost his balance there.
Yeah, now on the other three. No one on him. Wide open. And he drills it.
Well, you can't do that.
38-33 here. Under 6 minutes to play. Turner with it. Looking in the paint. Now gives it to Engelman. Drive to the basket. Floater is good. Honestly, thought that was going to get beat in the next week.
Yeah, I thought
Trey.
It was too. I mean, you just drove
Instead,
to the basket.
Instead, Noah Engelman has 7 points.
He's been good. Good pass
Backdoor
there.
Backdoor cut. Can't finish. Probably should have came down with it.
I think if he came down with it, he would have been too far under the basket. Yeah.
Holmes off to Nelson, and he finishes. Jarrett Nelson with 16 points. And he's putting in work in the paint.
He's having such a good game inside. And he's been playing great.
Jesus goes inside to Applin. Guarded by Nelson and just gets the layup to go. I probably would have let him just have it, too.
Yeah.
No point in contesting that one and getting a dumb foul. Combs inside to Engelman. What a pass, and he's blocked. A lot of body.
Ball doesn't get the foul. Ball does, in fact, not lie.
Nope. Ruffin with it. Inside to Engelman. Blocked.
Finally.
And a foul. Oh, Osborne wants to count it,
yeah.
Let's see.
That's a great pass.
It might have. I think it did.
No Engelman goes to the line either way.
We'll see Barry check in after this free throw. Go ahead.
Javon Porter picks up his second foul.
And Coach Osborne is not happy.
I would not be either. Both Osbornes aren't happy, actually.
There is not a happy Osborne in sight.
I like that.
Actually, Osborne's dad always looks pretty happy on the bench. I don't know.
He never changes. I don't know what. I can't read that guy.
Second free throw is good. It's again a 9-point lead in favor of the Eagles.
Almost turned it over there. Number one, James Lee. Not had much playing down tonight, but he's in the game right now.
Porter gets it in the paint and throws it down. Whoa. Javon Porter. That was kind of out of nowhere.
It was. That's only his.
See, if he can do that.
I have six. I have seven.
Combs to the basket. Can't finish. Barry's second chance won't go. Very rare for Barry to not be the tallest player on the floor. Three-pointer from Chivas. All of a sudden, it's a four-point game.
And Tavon Chivas. Is that his name?
Takai.
Takai Jr. Chivas. Goodness. I'm having issues. It's been a long day. He's been the main reason that they're back in this game.
Combs, pull-up jumper, missed everything wrong. Now Aaron Rowe on the other end, a chance to make it a one-possession game. Three in the corner from the other Porter, no good. Rebound will go to Colin Ruffin.
Ooh. Oh, he could have had a lob there.
Probably not the smartest play.
Yeah, could have put the game on ice, though. Good pass.
What a pass inside to Jordan Turner. That looked more like last year Colin Ruffin.
Yeah, we've been waiting on him to break through and get some good assists.
Ooh, almost backcourt.
Yeah.
Aaron Rowe with it. It's back to a six-point Eagle lead.
Well, Tolton Catholic got the switch they wanted with Colin Ruffin now on Javon Porter.
Isaac Porter. Ruffin's not scared, though, but the thing is you got Barry right here who's going to come and help. Charge, no call. And the finish by Porter.
He's finally coming alive. He's got eight now. Nine.
Ruffin across the timeline.
I don't know what it is. Could be eight, could be nine.
Very good. Something to ponder, I guess. How many points did Javon Porter really have? Turner tried a little bit of.
It almost worked.
Yeah. It would have been sick if it would have.
It would have been, yeah.
Bringing a screen. Kale Combs spinning.
Oh, that
got to be a foul.
Thank you.
Finally, they call it. Hey, Combs hit that. Maybe that's a good sign. So you didn't see something go through the basket.
Yeah.
Well, my
even if it doesn't count.
My prediction of 20 points, you know, not great, but team's got the lead.
Yeah. Only by four, though. You'd hope it's bigger and hope it gets it.
Hey, we reffed his game today.
Oh, we did.
Oh, it's cool. Colin Ruffin has it. Sorry, I just had to make you aware.
Well,
Ruffin,
open.
Step back, three. No good. Rebound, Colton Barry. What happened there?
Oh, Ruffin's
second
open.
Second try for Ruffin. No good. Eagles three-pointing just not. How many threes have we hit?
One? None?
No, one. Turner
hit one. Oh, yeah, Turner hit one. Of course he did.
Someone else hit one, no?
No, no one else hit one. Just Turner.
Not the shooting night, especially after they went 11 for 22 against Willard.
Well, that was a weird
play. That's going to.
It should be to Tolton, yeah. It was off Barry's leg. Surprised they
didn't
do a kick to that.
Here comes the man of the night, Jarrett Nelson, to check in.
Yeah, I'm really surprised they didn't give him a kickball for that, but they didn't give one to Anton Brookshire either.
Anton Brookshire, Trevin Brazil getting their first start from Mizzou today.
Really?
Yeah.
Been
a rough year for Mizzou, though.
It has been.
Lost to UMKC, Trey.
Isaac Haney, on the other hand.
Having a great year.
Got a foul here. I don't know who they're going to call it on, but about 18 people went to go help him up.
Despite the
the chippiness,
everyone went to go help him up. That's awesome.
They gave us to Jackson Bell. That's his first.
So a four-point game here. Haven't really had a bucket in a minute. Three-pointer on the way. Isaac Porter gets the shooter's roll. It's a one-point game. Oh, my goodness. It went out of bounds, and I don't think Combs is very happy about that because Coach Osborne was standing in his way.
This is a rough turn of events for Nick. So, I mean, Tolton has a chance to take the lead here. Noah Enelman not in the game. Got Jackson Bell and Porter. This is a matchup that I did not expect to see at all. Jarrett Nelson.
Jump ball, but it favors Tolton Catholic.
That's a good play by Nelson, though. Really nothing else he can do in that situation.
They get it into Aaron Rowe. Now across to Lee. It's a one-point game.
They're battling down on the inside.
Yes, Bell is doing a fantastic job. Through the lane, get it to Rowe somehow. It looked really weird. There was no travel.
It just looked awkward. That's why everyone wanted to travel. Oh, great
play. That's a charge.
Javon Porter picking up his third. What a play by Bell.
Let's give him a technical. I mean,
What? Everyone's wanting it. Now, Knicks has got to score on this possession.
This is, yes.
This
gotta
is a must score.
Nothing up the left sideline.
You think he's still talking to him? Because he didn't last time.
Yeah, probably. I wish he was on this sideline. Yeah. Too.
Oh, he definitely is. His mouth has been moving the entire time.
Ruffin with it. Gives it to Turner. Honestly, why not? Just jack it. He could probably hit it.
Well, Ruffin can hit it from here. I wouldn't like to see it, but.
Starts the 5-second clock. Now gives it off to Kale Combs.
Oh, what a
Euro
move.
Step. Gives it off to Nelson. Spins through the lane. They want 3 seconds. Don't get it, but no. The shot's no good anyways.
That ball on line. No one's on him, but that quickly changes. That's on the ground.
Chivas gets ground. It
That's
to go.
Ground.
Are they going to count
on the
this?
Ground.
No, on the ground.
He called it on the ground way before. But.
I wasn't looking at him. I was looking at the play. So.
Well, Jarrett Nelson picking up his first.
That's not
That's
right. got
to be his second. I have two.
Well, he definitely.
He definitely has two because we talked about it earlier.
Oh, what is going on? Up ahead, Jordan Turner. Can he finish? No, but he gets the and one. He can finish. I don't know why he said he couldn't. Oh, what a play by Jordan Turner. I was expecting to see what we saw against Parkview last year, where we miss it a little too hard, but Jared Nelson comes flying out of nowhere and finishes it. You remember that?
That
blue
was
and gold?
Wofford that missed that, and Jared Nelson came flying in.
And Turner's much like Wofford, so I was kind of expecting to see the same thing. But.
That was a lot more exciting. Yeah. I like the and one.
Great work there by Jackson Bell. He checks out, and something that 2 years ago, if you told Coach Osborne that he'd be applauding Jackson Bell's defensive effort, he might not have. He did a great job.
He did great.
Put in work.
Now they moved into his zone.
Yes.
With Ruffin kind of staying on Porter. They're kind of in a zone where someone's guarding Porter at all times. That's a turnover, and Nixes gets the chance for the last second shot here.
Who do you go to here?
Anyone, honestly.
I don't think you go for a three.
No. You got to get
it
inside.
This hasn't really worked. Combs has it now. He just doesn't look comfortable right now.
Tipped out of bounds. I mean, they're kind of shutting him down.
He
they're doing
look like
good
himself.
Job. See, that's the thing. They're shutting him down, but Jared Nelson has 16.
Jordan Turner has 14.
Jordan Turner has 14.
So for the second straight night, Jordan Turner's going to be one of the top scorers tonight.
Yeah.
They get it to Jared Nelson.
Oh,
tried
man,
to make
Barry.
A pretty pass. Didn't work. Aaron Rowe going to jump with Kale Combs. Can't finish. But a chance to shoot, too, with 6 seconds to go. Kale Combs not happy with that foul. He really needs to be careful.
Yeah, he's got one tag. He's got three. Aaron Rowe going to launch. Make it a one-possession game here. Jackson Bell's going to check. This is a weird lineup for Father Tolton coming in.
You know what kind of lineup it is? It's we've got three players with three fouls. Let's go ahead and put in someone that if they foul, it really does not matter.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is, just to be honest with you.
Well, he makes the first free throw to make it a one possession game, and Javon Porter's out. Are both the Porter? No, never mind.
So you know what really frustrates me and might sound dumb as the free throw goes? The fact that Kale Combs is just trying to ask. Right?
Yeah.
But instead, the ref points him out there. It's almost like, I made the bad call, but I'm not going to talk to you about it. You know what I'm saying? 2 seconds to go. They give it off to Combs. He got it off in time.
Oh, man.
Can't finish. Another thriller, Trey.
We got another one. Yeah,
it's
2-point game.
49-47. Let's step aside here from Eagle Fieldhouse in the Tri-Lakes shootout. Eagles lead by two. One more quarter to play. Back after this.
Hi, Jim here with Wise Guy Screen Print. I'd like to show you why Wise Guy Screen Print is the wise choice for all your screen print and embroidery needs. Experienced printers, state-of-the-art equipment, ensure a perfect product every time, a fully staffed art department, and never a charge to help you with your logo and design. We're your go-to for fundraising and corporate projects with hats, shirts, jackets, and polos. At Wise Guy Screen Print, we make t-shirt dreams come true.
Eight more minutes of action here. I'm sad. It's kind of, our day is coming to the end, Trey.
I know.
It's been two amazing basketball games. Turner with it right side. Gets it to Bell. I'd say they've got a very specific shot they want here to kick off the
They're definitely second, running a set play quarter. Right now. Had Barry on the inside for a very split second, but
that's going to go out of bounds
and it'll be Nixa
stay
ball.
With Nixa, yeah.
So, not the best thing you wanted, but not the worst. It's still Nixa ball.
No, you're running. The clock's your friend until you lose the lead.
Yeah.
So the Eagles really don't play many games this low scoring, but you're going to see one here tonight.
Parkview's one of them. That'll be low
Parkview's
scoring
Parkview's always
time.
One of them, yeah.
That's a good play.
Rough in 4-3, just short. And everything's been just a little short from three tonight for the Eagles.
Yeah, I mean, they...
That's the Porter for the lead. No good. Rebound by Ruffin. Turner coming up a little. I don't know what's up with that.
I don't know, but he's got the ball.
Yeah, some with his hand.
Someone's open.
Jackson Bell for three. And the foul. Who else but Jackson Bell to get a chance for a four-point play. Coach Osborne broke his marker.
Goodness. That's Aaron Rose fourth.
On the
That's
freshman
not good.
Guard. There's one thing I've learned from my basketball career. What's going on here?
He broke his marker.
Gotta go get the marker. The rest of the marker. If there's one thing I've learned, though, it's don't jump
with
Jackson Bell
because
he's
going to
shoot the three-pointer because he's going to get the and one 9 times out of 10.
Yeah, he... I don't know why, but whenever he gets fouled, he suddenly turns into Stephen Curry and he can't miss.
Yeah. Seven
I mean,
out of
a, big, a big, big 7-point swing in the second quarter against Bentonville West with two and one threes. Just couldn't make the free throw on the second one. But
no, they didn't call the second one,
oh,
even though he got drilled.
It was more of
a foul than the first one, but they didn't call it.
Yeah, well, a 4-point swing there.
Now it's a 6-point
game. That's
much more comfortable lead.
Six looks a lot better than two on the scoreboard.
Yes. Blocked by Cale Combs and a foul. He wants it to be on...
Bell?
Luckily, they no.
I know. It shouldn't be on Bell. It shouldn't be on Combs either.
I'd say Bell probably just raised his hand really quick and said, "Hey, it's on me."
Yeah. Justin Boyer held scoreless in the third quarter, large part to foul trouble.
First free throw on the way. It's good.
Jared Nelson going to come in for Barry, and I really like this lineup. I think this might be the best lineup that Nixa has.
I do like this lineup. You know what that whole situation with Bell just raising his hand really quick remind me of?
What?
The Dora incident where they would
the triplets were
changing jerseys and all that stuff.
Yeah, that one was weird.
Nelson gives it off to Engelman. Now Cale Combs inside out for three. Bang! Maybe not his best night, but that's a big three-point basket right there.
Gives Nixa a 7-point lead. I mean, trading threes for twos, that's not the thing that Father Tolton wants.
No. Gives us a chance to talk to someone new tonight.
Yeah.
Combs, what a play. Gives
play.
It off to Nelson.
That is just the athlete of him. Yeah.
Having a bad game, but he's not going to open about it. Still going to go out there and do everything he can to get a win. Ruffin with it up top. 6:15 to play. Nelson.
Good play.
It's Bell and the and one. Jackson Bell fired up.
Oh, my.
What a play out of him.
Jackson Bell has come alive here in the fourth quarter. Just whenever you need someone to need someone like that just to come in and just start scoring.
He said, I'll take your three stars and turn them into 3 points. All right.
I like that. You said a lot of things that I like tonight. You're saying
it's been
something.
It's been
else.
A good day. Free throw on the way up. I was really hoping he'd make that. It's a 10-point Eagle lead here at Eagle Fieldhouse, and
Well, that's a quick 10 points here in the fourth quarter from Combs and Bell.
Yeah.
Anyone can expect one of those people to have a lot of points, but not the other one.
That's 11 out of Kale Combs, or Jackson Bell tonight.
What good finish.
Yeah, good there. Yeah, that's a really good finish.
Sakai Chivas has definitely been the player of the game for Tolton tonight.
Yes.
He's got 12.
In a game where Javon Porter's only got 9 points.
Yeah. Timeout, Nixa.
Wow.
One of the few timeouts that Nixa's called. Is that the first?
Yes.
There has not been a lot of timeouts. Both teams have only called one, and that'll be a full timeout.
Both teams have just kind of let their teams play. We'll go ahead and step aside. 5:40 to play here in the fourth quarter. It's Nixa 59, Tolton 51. Back after this from the Dry Lake Shootout. We're back here at Eagle Field House. It's 59-51. Trey, I just got a question for you, all right? Right, North Carolina.
Okay. Don't need to talk about that.
They're losing to Kentucky right now.
I don't want
to
hear it.
Can you remind me who beat Kentucky?
I don't want to hear it.
Who upset Kentucky? That's right. My Fighting Irish.
Keyword upset.
My Fighting Irish upset Kentucky. Colin Ruffin with it up top. Kale Combs thought about the three, maybe on another night.
Nope.
He's going to take that one. No good. You know, Noah Engelman had position.
Oh, what a pass.
Wow. Maybe that's what it is. He's a three-star quarterback. That was a dime.
That wasn't a very popular call, but I agree with that one.
That one was
definitely a foul. You'll take it, though.
Yeah. And Nelson has a few to give. I told you, if he doesn't get all four, he's getting cheated.
Or five. You never know. You know, whenever we showed him, that's a... close, very close to a try.
Inside out basketball for three. Bang! James Lee makes it
finally
a
on the
game.
Board. Took James Lee.
Nope, he has three. 5 points.
Okay.
I don't know how. We'll find out after the game whenever we see the actual book. You know? They bring a screen.
Okay, that was a big flop.
Roughing around it. Bell to Engelman. Now Combs. I'd say the Eagles need to run some clock on this possession.
Yeah, they're up by five, but it could slip away very fast with how good Father Tolton is.
Yes. Into the paint, Jarrett Nelson.
Oh, my.
What happened? I can't even see what's happening.
That's a foul.
Engelman blocked.
What a pass.
Jackson Bell for three. Bang! Who cares? We don't need the two. We need the three. Now on the other end, that's a jump ball.
Oh, my.
Jackson Bell is having himself a game.
He's not having himself a game. He's having himself a fourth quarter right now.
Oh.
Wow.
I know he was disappointed after his Willard performance. Only had 4 points.
He has 14.
Tried for the answer there. No good. Second chance. And he does. Dude, Nelson's on the ground. I don't know what is going on right now. You don't want Ruffin inbounding the ball.
No.
I know that. But honestly,
back to what I was saying. Jackson Bell is 14. He only had four going into the fourth.
Yes.
He's turning into Kale Combs against Parkview.
Ruffin going to drive using his right hand. We don't honestly see him use his right hand that much, and that's going to be a carry. You know, if that was Anton Brookshire, it would not have been tough. That's all I've got to say.
Let's not go there. We don't need to go there right now.
James Lee with it across the timeline. It doesn't matter. Colin's still going to talk. I couldn't do that.
But why not?
He holds it. Now gives it off to Javon Porter. And I'm not going to say it yet. Never mind. I'll wait till the end of the game. Pull up jumper, and he's fouled. Go to the line to shoot, too.
You know, with how good Noah's played on defense, that's his first foul.
It's just a
that's
really
impressive. He is. I could watch him play defense all day.
He's just a really good defender. I mean, there's really no way around it.
Javon Porter shooting his first free throws of the night, I believe. At least in my book, that is. Hey, ball don't lie.
Oh, good. No, I think it was a foul.
I don't care. I still want to say it.
So the first free throw, no good.
See, but that's a good foul, though. Yes. Even if he makes this one, and he does, that's a good foul. I mean, it traded two for one. And it's a four-point game instead of a three-point game, which is a lot better.
Yeah. 3:16 to play here in the fourth quarter. Combs putting the dribble moves on. Hesitation out to Jackson Bell. I really thought we would have saw him take that.
I thought we would, too. What a move by Engelman,
Noah
though.
Engelman now with it. Can't finish. Gets his own rebound. Finds Kale Combs. One
Bell
more to Jackson Bell for three. Bang! It's a high five to Sam Russo while he's at it. And now Jarrett Nelson with a steal.
Oh, my.
Whoa.
Jackson Bell is having himself a fourth quarter right now.
17 for Jackson Bell. He'll give it off to Kale Combs. He got two lefties with it on the right side now, but Colin Ruffin wide open. Still can't hit it for three, and Bell's already back on defense.
That's not something that we think that we would say at all. No Engelman, though. Sets a screen.
Javon Porter pass out a shot for the dunk and can't finish.
And Engelman gets the rebound. Oh, my. That was a big turn of events.
Don't leave him open. Okay, they didn't. I think they've learned to know the name.
Okay. Well, I mean, he scored, 13 in the fourth quarter alone?
Oh, they're going to have a timeout. Okay, I thought they were going to say hit out of bounds. All right, we're not going anywhere. We need to talk about Jackson Bell real quick. I mean,
has he missed a three here in the fourth quarter?
Let's not talk about it yet. Let's not. Look at that finish, though. And now let's get the we cut it off. I was hoping we got the flex in there. See, that's a foul.
Yeah, that's a foul. That's a good pass.
I'm just very impressed. Where's the Jordan Turner check in here?
If he's not coming in for Jackson Bell, we got a very high-powered lineup.
Yeah,
that's Tolton.
Let's take a break real quick. It's 65-58. Knicks over 5 at Tolton. 2:03 to play at the Tri-Lake Shootout. Back after this. Back here at the Tri-Lake Shootout, it's 65-58, Knicks over Tolton Catholic in what has been an amazing game number three tonight.
Yeah, it's. I mean, we've had three really good games.
Yes,
I think the Arnold twins have proved that they are some of the best girls basketball players in the state right now.
I think they both had 25.
I mean, they combined for what a pass!
They get into Jarrett Nelson, power dribble, the layup, and
Jarrett's got 20.
Potentially a bucket to put this one away. Jumper on the other end, no good. Rebound being tipped around. Javon Porter counts the basket. How did he finish that?
I don't know. That's impressive.
Let's watch this finish. I'm fine with Jackson Bell playing defense like that. I just don't know how he finished that.
Yeah, I mean, that's really good defense if you're playing against someone besides him.
Free throw, no
good.
That'd
be short. Oh, he gets the
that's
rebound.
That's not good. And the slam. Maybe I shouldn't have said that before I put the game away. Timeout, Tolton Catholic.
And it's a five-point game.
Yeah, all of a sudden. Just
no,
after you
normally check
it
back in.
Just after I said the game was over, it's a five-point game.
Yeah, why did you say that?
I don't know. We'll step aside here in Nixa. It's 67-62. back after the break. Back at Eagle Fieldhouse, it's 67-62. A minute 38 to play. They inbound it to Ruffin here. Nixa shooting the rest of the way. Oh, Turner travel.
Yep.
Ruffin gives it off to Combs. Combs through the lane, he'll dribble it back out.
They're definitely taking a clock here.
Yes.
I mean, you have to. There's a minute and a half left, and it's a five-point game.
Mayo Combs wide open with a minute 18 to go. Now back up top to Ruffin. Combs has it right side. They'll play a little catch. High post, Noah Engelman. He'll dribble it back out, go to Turner. Well, now Jackson Bell.
Yeah, he was open.
He doesn't even
like
want
that.
The layup.
Oh,
and now
my.
They foul,
oh, my.
And that is a flagrant foul, right?
They don't have flagrant in high school.
Okay, intentional.
Yeah.
Look, I get going over and, you know, grabbing the guy, but he shoved
pushed
it with
him.
Two
yeah.
hands and extended it. Either way, Ruffin going to line to shoot.
Jared Nelson going to come in for Turner. Definitely need some more defense in there.
Need one of these, would like two of them.
Well, it's just a one-on-one, so he really needs to make the first.
The first
one.
In, yes. Ruffin's free throw.
Oh,
no
my.
Good.
It's a two-possession game.
You know, if it was up to me, I probably would have put someone in the lane right there.
Yeah.
Because you never know. Noah Engelman got one against Parkview with just having himself in there.
Yeah, that was impressive.
Javon Porter to the bucket and the lay. Well, it's a three-point game, Trey.
You know what's crazy is, I'm not saying it was, but Jared Nelson got a foul call for something far less than a wraparound of that. That one wasn't, but Jared Nelson got one, like,
true.
It was less than that.
Just
of course, that was against Bentonville West.
Yes. Just a 30-second timeout here. It's 67-64. Nixa leads. Nixa shooting the double bonus the rest of the way.
That's big.
Yep. Tolton in the 1-1 for a little bit. Two timeouts for Tolton, three for Nixa. You've got Aaron Rowe with four and James Lee with four.
James Lee definitely hasn't had the same game that Aaron Rowe has, but Aaron Rowe has 10, hasn't had any on the fourth.
Javon Porter and Evans Applin both have three, and then did Boyer already foul? No, Boyer's on the court now. He has three as well.
Yeah.
So foul trouble.
Everyone on the court besides Chibius has four or three.
Yeah.
Three or four fouls. Gets it into Combs.
Now back to Bell. And he's ripped.
Jordan Turner almost got the steal, though.
Now Boyer has it. 40 seconds to play.
Can't give up a three or an and one.
And they get the layup to go. Timeout, Tolton Catholic.
Oh, my goodness.
Uh-oh. It was just, what, a 10-point game?
Almost. It was a 9-point game earlier, I believe.
Yeah. Wow.
But, as we said earlier, very few timeouts being called, and all of a sudden, there's been a lot.
One timeout left for Tolton.
Yeah, three for Nixa. They haven't been using theirs, but they haven't needed to whenever Tolton calls a timeout after every basket. Nixa's got a score.
66. You need a bucket here. Or
Well, you can't turn the ball over. That's definitely
it. Yeah, so what I'm thinking is, right, you want to get the ball to Jackson Bell.
Yeah.
He's definitely your best free throw shooter on the
hey,
team.
Knock on wood, but Jared Nelson has only missed one free throw tonight.
I hope you can hear that on the stream. I'm knocking very loudly.
Jordan Turner's only missed one, and Jackson Bell has yet to miss one, and Noah Engelman's only missed one. So you got good free throw shooting. for the Eagles so far. We are knocking very loudly on wood right now.
Yeah, why
trying to get that to
that
count.
Down.
I don't know, okay. But I noticed it. I mean, they've only
no
missed.
Matter what, though, you're shooting two at the line, so at least,
yeah.
You know.
But you would like to make both of them. We've had two very good games, though.
67-66, almost identical scores, too. The first one ended 69-67.
So. Yeah, still end identical. Got Jacksonville open, but he also has Colin Ruffin, and it'll very close.
Cool.
But it'll be tipped out of bounds by
Tolton. I don't think
Tolton.
You want your point guard to throw it away like that.
Yeah.
33.6. Get it into Jackson Bell, and now Kale Combs with it. Up ahead, Jordan Turner.
We're going to take clock off.
Oh, God, you don't want to throw the ball there. And we got a foul, thankfully. I don't know if there was a foul.
I'm not sure if there was or not. Almost split it, though. Ooh. Kale Combs going to the line for two.
Two big ones.
I don't know who that foul is on. It's Javon Porter, his fourth. That's not good. Jared Nelson going to check in after the first free throw.
He'll come in for Jordan Turner, I'm sure.
Yeah.
And two big free throws here for Kale Combs. First one on the way, and good.
Ooh, got the shooter's roll on that one. That was almost rimmed in and out.
Jared Nelson into the game. So a little more comfortable here. You want to get the next one, but.
Well, look, they got Noah Engelman down there now. Watch him get a rebound.
Put the game
I
on
hope
ice,
he,
get
I
a
hope
rebound.
He doesn't.
Yeah, I hope he doesn't either. Yeah, he doesn't.
Good.
So identical score to our last game between Blair Oaks and Ozark. It's 69-66, and this one's going to come down to the wire. 20 seconds to go. The freshman point guard, Aaron Rowe, with it. He gives it off to three-star Javon Porter to the rack. No good. Rebound by Colin Ruffin, and a foul. And the crowd goes wild.
Noah Engelman is the best defensive player on this team right now. He has
Look,
shut down three-star Javon Porter.
Here's what we're not going to do tonight, all right? We're not going to do a player of the game, and here's why.
You can't give it to someone.
Who are you giving it to?
You got
Jared
Nelson
with 18. Go ahead.
Jackson Bell, he's got a lot of points, and Noah Engelman. I mean, he's
it's
had a lot of
it's
points.
It's a team effort.
It's a team effort,
they
yeah.
They won the game.
Yeah, you can't give it up. You
I
can't
mean,
give
you
a player of the game.
You can't give a player of the game tonight. Jarrett Nelson, fantastic game. Jackson Bell, huge fourth quarter. Colin Ruffin, huge free throw. And then Noah Engelman, potentially the single most impressive defensive effort I've seen out of anyone all year.
Oh, yeah. And timeout, Knicks. Will be a full timeout. One free throw left, 9 seconds to go, and it's a four-point game
and
for the
here's
Eagles.
Here's the thing. Tolton does have a timeout, so it's not over.
It's not
it's
over.
Not like
it's definitely not
yeah.
over. I mean, if they come down and make a shot with, like, 4 seconds to go and they don't have a timeout, it's over because Nixon doesn't even have to throw the ball in. But if they – since they have a timeout, they can hit a shot, call a timeout quick, and hopefully get a steal or something off the inbound. So it's not over.
No,
it's
not.
Nowhere near from over. What a team effort from the Eagles,
yeah.
though.
You know,
everyone that got in besides Keith Pietmeyer scored. And Keith was only in the game for about 30 seconds.
Yeah.
We still don't know why that happened.
Yeah.
That was such
that
a
was
random play.
Very weird.
He came in for Ruffin.
So, here's the deal. This could really affect Tolton Catholic season because they don't play again until after Christmas. It's a really long time to sit and think about what could have been.
Yeah.
If you would have won the night, you know.
It would have been. It would have been. I mean, it wouldn't have been the same thing for Knicks because they play next Monday night against Fayetteville.
They played. Yeah. You know, very short turnaround.
I'm sure they'll have practice tomorrow. Yeah.
And that's something that we heard from Coach Schweitzer. They've got Kickapoo on Tuesday in a big district matchup.
Yeah.
And this no days off.
Gauntlet of a district.
Yeah. Aaron Rowe and
the steal.
Colin Ruffin. He's
oh
going to dunk it and put it away. Colin Ruffin can indeed dunk.
What a time to
That's
do this first
the game.
Dunk.
Nixa takes this one 73-66 over Tolton Catholic. What a fantastic performance.
I thought he was going to give that to Combs, but Colin Ruffin
he
can
indeed
in fact
dunk.
Dunk. What a time to get your first one, too. Oh, my.
Wow. There's so much to talk about, Trey. Let's start with what a great win. Coach Osborne giving a fist pump. You know it's a big win when he's fist pumping. All right?
He's smiling. How about that?
Incredibly
I have never seen that
right
before.
Now.
Oh, my.
I talked to Blantz. I talked to Osborne. They thought this would show us what kind of team they were.
Yeah.
And they just showed what kind of team they are. Nixa.
They're
the number two team in the state, at least. I mean.
You got to be. I mean, there's no reason why you can leave Nixa behind Chaminade after showing like this. And after Chaminade lost by, what, 11 to this Father Tolton team?
Yes. And
honestly, I don't know who Liberty has played recently, but you could put them above Liberty. I mean, Nixa has played so good.
Yeah.
This is, oh my.
So let's go ahead. Let's talk about our players of the game real quick.
Players,
the team, really.
Yeah.
But Jared Nelson, 18 amazing points.
Hey, we're using a shot clock in this game.
Well, it did that last game, too. 17 out of Jackson Bell. What a performance. 9 out of Engelman.
17 out of Jackson Bell, and 13 of them coming in the fourth. He had the best fourth quarter that
part of why they won.
That anyone besides Caleb Combs against Parkview has had so far this season. It was so impressive starting with that and-1 three, and then he got another and-1 very close to the basket, and then a couple more threes here in the fourth quarter. That was just such an impressive showing by Jackson Bell.
Yeah, so Nixa wins a big one, 73 to what, 67?
66.
66. And they improved to 4-0 on the year, heading into a big interstate matchup against Fayetteville, Arkansas on Monday night. We all knew what kind of game that was last year.
Yeah.
Should be heading for another good
should
one.
Should be another one,
on
yeah.
On Monday night.
Coach White from Bentonville West wants us to beat him by 20, though. I'm not sure he's a big fan of Fayetteville.
I don't think they like
Fayetteville watching.
Too much.
Yes. But that's pretty much Ozark or Kick Boot Nixa rivalry that we have up here.
So, again, recap of today's games. Blue Eye over Tipton in the girls' matchup of the day. Ozark over Blair Oaks in a thriller. Nixa over Tolton Catholic in another thriller. And we'll go ahead. We're going to sign off, give it away to our huddle camera that'll stream Springfield Catholic versus Fulton. From Nixa High School, I'm Ryan Retone alongside my partner,
Trey Hartwell,
signing off. Thank you.